Hi, my name is Gabriel Ha, and we're going to showcase how to make a classifier through a process called feature extraction, which uses deep neural networks in combination with classic machine learning tools. First, what is a feature? A feature in the context of deep learning isn't really all that different from how you'd normally think of a feature in everyday life. If you're shopping around for a TV, and you want to know what makes this TV any different from any other TV, you'll generally look at its list of features. How big is it? How many pixels per inch? Who manufactured it? How much does it cost? These features like price or dimension or resolution are shared amongst all TVs, but the fact that this TV has one set of values and that TV has another set is what differentiates them, or classifies them, if you will. So this is the same sort of thing that deep learning classifiers figure out when they go through training, with the added bonus that not only are they differentiating features, but they're also determining what the actual features are in the first place. For example, the very first layer, which looks at the raw input image, might be learning basic things like where edges and blobs are in the image. As you go to deeper and deeper layers of the neural network, those layers combine the information they get from the earlier layers and form higher level image features, perhaps things like the object's overall shape. While feature extraction does require good knowledge of machine learning techniques, unlike other classifier construction methods done entirely with neural networks, feature extraction is super quick, requires very little data, and you don't even need good hardware to get good results in not that much time. Our goal is to make a classifier on images of four animals: cats, dogs, frogs, and deer. As a point of reference, we've previously created a network from scratch and a network using transfer learning to accomplish the same classification task. Those networks took around 45 and 250 seconds to train, respectively, with overall accuracies of 75 and 85%. And just to keep us honest, we're going to use the same set of images to train and test our new classifier. Now, in the world of machine learning, you have resources like the multi-class SVM classifier at your disposal, and these techniques run and learn really, really fast. But they require an initial list of features that you have to supply. Ah, so now you see where this is going. So for our task at hand, let's say you have this machine learning knowledge and you'd like to take advantage of compelling, thoughtful classification work that's already been done, like with AlexNet, a convolutional neural network which has been trained to classify 1,000 objects. So we're going to import AlexNet, and with this line of code, we pull in all its layers. Generally, the deepest layer of the network right before the layer that actually starts classifying things is a good place to start for feature extraction. So this single line of code extracts the features from that layer, and now we can give it to our machine learning classifier as a starting point. Here, we're going to have MATLAB train our multi-class SVM classifier using just 50 images of each animal, compared to 500 and 5,000 images per animal used in the other classifier construction techniques. We're going to drop each set of images in its own folder, point MATLAB to the data, and tell it to start running. Now, normally with demos like this, we'd be like, okay, so we tell it to run, and through the magic of post-production, we cut out the wait time. But in this case, let's see some magic without the post-production. Check it out. It literally took barely 2 seconds to extract the features, a fraction of a second to create the classifier, and when we run this against our test set of 1,000 images each, its overall accuracy is already 74%. So with good knowledge of machine learning, you can use MATLAB to generate a decent classifier with way less data, much less time, and without a dependence on good hardware. Click on the links below to get your hands on this code and try it out for yourself, and don't hesitate to leave us feedback.